morning, my brothers and sisters in Christ, and let's dive into the Word. Today we begin the octave of immediate preparation for the birth of Christ. After this octave, we enter into the beautiful and glorious solemnity of Christmas. In today's Gospel, we encounter the long genealogy of Christ. The genealogy spans the whole history of salvation, from Abraham on through David, right up to the birth of Jesus. There are many names mentioned, many characters, many men, a few women, all with from different backgrounds, with different stories, peculiar nonetheless with their own idiosyncrasies. If there's one thing we're all well aware of about Jesus' lineage, is that Jesus had an imperfect family line. But one thing we can also be sure of is that God had long begun the groundwork for the coming of his Son. I'd like to share two things that we could take away from this passage. The first is that our God is a faithful God. Yes, it may have taken centuries and generations, but through Jesus' birth, God fulfilled his promise to Abraham. Through all the different seasons and peoples and generations, God stuck to his word till the end, and we now have a Savior, our Savior. This also tells us that God's timing and his ways are perfect. His ways may not be our ways. His timeline may skew away from what we have had planned. Sometimes we have our own plans for how we want our lives to pan out. When we want to get a degree, when we want to get married, what job we want to have had secured by a certain age, how we want to run our ministries, what we want our children to do with their lives. Yes, our plans and ideas may be good, and we sure hope for them to come to pass. But when they don't come to pass, we often seem to be discouraged, either in ourselves, in the people around us, or our hopes for the future. As we reach the end of 2022, let's reflect on how the past year has been. Has everything we planned out come to pass? Or has God intervened in ways and areas we didn't expect? Either in the past year or concurrently, has God called us into a season of patience and waiting? Does he want our complete trust? Does he require us to surrender our own ideas and ambitions? As we step into the new year, let's re-evaluate our relationship with God and recommit our lives and plans to God as we allow him to guide us in every aspect of our lives, knowing with all our heart that his ways are good and his timing is perfect. Have a blessed day ahead.